taking care of a newborn baby is a total learning experience, and as you probably know by now, a ton of work. Being patient and taking things one at a time can help, but it also helps to learn some of the how-tos parents need to know. That's why we made this video series to help with at-home newborn care. For example, there may come a time when you will need to know if your baby has a fever, and the best way to find out is to measure the temperature of your baby. Why would you need to know? Well, one reason might be that your baby is not feeding as usual, or the baby may feel particularly warm to the touch, or maybe your baby is crying nonstop and nothing you have tried has worked to comfort your baby, or maybe the crying takes place in the middle of the night and you awake to find your baby is both hot and sweaty. There are three standard ways to take a person's temperature: oral, in the mouth, rectal, in the bottom, and axillary, under the arm. Of these three ways, only two are recommended for an infant under the age of three. These are the axillary and the rectal temperatures. It's not a bad idea to know how to take your baby's temperature using these two ways. But keep in mind that while the axillary temperature is good for a quick check, if you call into the doctor's office, your pediatrician will definitely want to know the rectal temperature because it is the most accurate. Now you don't have to wait until your baby is crying from a fever to take the temperature for the first time. There's nothing wrong with practicing how to. Just pick a convenient time when your baby is calm and relaxed. Use a digital thermometer. Most of the digital ones are designed to be used for all three standard ways. But make sure the package indicates that it can be used for the way you want. Actually, for children under 3 years, it is a good idea to have two thermometers, one for axillary and one for rectal temperature taking. Carefully read the instructions that come with the thermometer so you'll know how it works. You've probably heard of the in-the-ear electronic thermometers, but here's the scoop on these devices. Although they are quick and easy for older infants and young children, for newborns, they aren't as accurate as the rectal temperature taken with a digital thermometer. When you call the doctor's office, you'll want to give them the most accurate information about your baby. To start, place your baby down face up on a firm surface. A table or changing table is fine. Loosen the diaper. Clean the end of the digital thermometer using a tissue with rubbing alcohol or soap and cool water. Do not wash or rinse it with hot water. Then place a small amount of lubricant on the end, such as petroleum jelly. Then turn the thermometer on, making sure it's powered up. Next, bend the baby's legs toward the chest and insert the end, 1/2 inch to 1 inch, into the baby's anal opening. Do not insert it more than 1 inch. Hold the thermometer in place, loosely holding the baby's legs. Keep it there until you hear the beep, about a minute. Then remove it and check the digital reading on the display. Clean the thermometer after each use. Wipe it with tissue and then with rubbing alcohol or soap and water. Dry the thermometer before putting it away. It is a good idea to mark this thermometer for rectal use so you don't use it anywhere else. To take your baby's temperature under the arm, the axillary temperature, lay the baby down on a firm surface. A table, a changing table, or a crib is fine. Lift one arm up and place the thermometer under the arm with the tip pressing in the center of the armpit. Now bring the arm down, making sure it is in line with the thermometer. Gently hold the arm down until the thermometer beeps. After it beeps, take it out and read the temperature, making note of the reading. If the under-the-arm temperature is over 99 degrees, you'll want to verify this, taking your baby's rectal temperature. If the rectal temperature is 100.4 degrees or higher, call the doctor's office. And remember to tell them which way it was taken. They'll want to know that. If you are concerned, it is always best to call your doctor rather than worry. Having a digital thermometer in your home and knowing how to use it are important steps to take. You'll feel better knowing you can take your baby's temperature if you need to. We hope this at-home newborn care video has helped. Look for our other newborn care videos.